我不是故意的，每次都发誓一定准时到。还不晓得什么情况还是会晚呢、啊、我不是因为我故意的呢，我真的不喜欢。比方说昨天呢、啊、同事告诉我11点要准备好要发奖嘛，我11点都准备好了呢，啊，我就打电话下去问他，我现在下去了哈，准备好了哈。他说还不行，师傅等一下，啊，几分钟再下来。我说你告诉我11点，现在我已经准备好了，不行，我要下来。哎，然后我就真的想要下来了，因为我都准备好头发，怎么弄好衣服都装好，化妆都好，高跟鞋也装好了，没有一点问题。想开车了，结果啊肚子痛。然后你知道那种你们那种陷害的那种旗袍啊，豪宅啊，要去哪里啊，要拖起来啊，哦，要再转回去啊，哦，头发要坏掉啊，哦，再弄啊，受不了。然后亮来亮去还是快12点才下来。真没办法，我不是故意的。像昨天我最高兴的，因为11点我已经准时了，哦，什么都好了，还打电话恐吓同，因为他每一次都急我，他那个属老鼠都很急的。我在这边有几只老鼠，每一次都紧紧张张，其实啊，比方说我上飞机啊，3点要到啊，他一定跟我说2点，然后。然后我把从我房子有那个什么很舒服的把我抓起来，在那个高速公路那边享受好的空气，然后跑到那个气墙在那边享受那个臭烟啊，人的汗啊，还有 perfume 啊，香水什么味道，1个小时，嗯，这样子，然后才可以慢慢来上飞机。这样子，他每次都这样子，啊，几年以来都一样。然后我比如他每次都骑骑这样，我也讲不出来是什么不对的地方，就是我知道他骑骑这样，他骑谁都可以，他骑他的老板呢。他整个办公室都知道他这个个性都骑了，不过他也忘记，他也把我算在内。也是办公室是其中一个里面，他随便这样公司，哎呀，讲不完了，讲不完故事。骑完了几个老鼠都是很吵，今天早上吵我也是同也是老鼠的，啊，然后刚才叫上去那个吵我好几年，到现在也是一个老鼠的，然后今天要我剪裁他那个木工厂也是一个老鼠的，你看我受得了吗？啊，啊，老鼠个性就这样子嘛，转转的很快，他不是故意的，故意的还不得了。不小心已经这个样子了。我们这边动物园呢，啊，什么各样动物都有，然后每天都忍耐他们个性就会很累。It's better now, really? No? No? Then you hear nothing? You do or you don't? No? But you stay here or not?
Just applause.
Applause, then you cannot hear.The Taiwanese people, I cannot tell them. I tell them many times, wait until after. But they always do it. Oh, try to put up with it. Okay, I will talk to you in English tonight or tomorrow if you stay, okay? Exclusively, okay? actually, today I already wanted to speak English. It's just as the majority, you know, make me struggle. And that's what makes me also frustrated and bad mood. Because...Really, it's difficult to deal with languages in this world, so many languages. But most people understand English, those who came from abroad, even Japanese or, you know, Korean, they understand, and Vietnamese understand. Just the Taiwanese, they don't understand. And even they don't understand Chinese, can you believe it? Many people sit behind there and need translation, because they always speak Taiwanese. I can never win.So many languages in the world. Even if I start from my birth, I can never finish. And even if I can finish, I cannot speak all the time, one time in different languages. That's the problem. I feel sorry for you. Yes, I really sympathize with you because you came from such a long way. And very rarely do Occidental people sit with their long legs on the floor and suffer so much. But you relax, you do what you want, okay? You can kick the neighbor and have more room. Otherwise, what can I do? They like to squeeze in the front. The closer, the better. But actually, people say when you want to improve in your class, you should sit in the front, the first row, next to the teacher. That's according to research, yeah. Why is sitting in the front the best? They say the best students are always the ones who sit in the front row. I can testify to that. I was the best student, and I sat in the front row. Maybe because I sat in the front row that I was the best student. One of the two or three best, yeah? Yeah, always the first or the second or the third in the class. Maybe because I sat in the front, I don't know. But that's what they say. The best student, that's the one who sits in the front. But later they found out why. The ones who sit right in the back, you know, or from the half or middle, they're very distracted. They don't pay attention to what the teacher says that much as the ones who sit in the front. Maybe because when you sit in the front, the teacher is there. You cannot fiddle, you know. You cannot write names on the school table and things like that. And those from the half back, they always write on the table. But never the front row. Never the front one or two rows, you see. Yeah, and now I remember, those who sit in the first one or two rows are always the good students. The best ones are in my class, yeah, in my classes that I remember. Why I always sat in the front, because I was the smallest in the class. The teacher will take me and put me in the front, even when I was in India, in any ashram, any master, any teacher. Even if I sat right in the back, he always said, come here, you little one. Yeah, I always enjoy, you know, spoiling like that. So when you sit in the front, you should be very fortunate and lucky and happy. You should not disturb the teacher. And you should not disturb the whole congregation because you are right in the front. Whatever you do, they see. Whatever you do, disturb them. Distract them. That's a terrible karma when you disturb the whole congregation of Buddhas. Huh? Look like Buddha. Okay, now. 你们都听懂了哈? Oh. 没问题. I'm very sorry, but I will speak to you in English another time, okay? Because most of them are Taiwanese, and they don't see me as much as you do. It's the same thing, because I don't stay here anymore. I used to, huh? But now I come now and again, only a few days, so they also have the right to listen to my speech. I'm very sorry that the word is imperfect. There's so many different languages, even among you, the white flags. How many languages? Swedish, Dutch, French, huh? Hollandish, Belgian. They speak Hollandish, all kinds. Yeah, even in one country, sometimes they speak three languages, like in Switzerland, huh? Italian, French, German, huh? And sometimes sprinkle English in between. And in England, sometimes they speak Yorkshire, and you understand nothing. Or in Germany, when they speak Bavarian, oh, I surrender. You know what I mean? Huh? Right? Yeah. Only in Vietnam, they speak the same language with little different accents, but we understand each other. In China, there are 120 plus different dialects, and no one understands the others. Even in India, from the south, I don't understand the north. Bombay doesn't understand Tamil, Nadu, etc., etc. Ah, it's so terrible. Sometimes I just don't want to look at the world anymore. How can you work, huh? But that's the problem. That's the fault of the Babel Tower. Hmm? Babel Tower, you know, the blah, 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 blah tower. 你们都懂了哈? 没问题哈? I asked them if they all understood. No problem. Okay, 我刚才跟他们说了那个, 他们, but do you want to leave now? 你们要走吗? Yeah. 有没有要走的人举手啊? 那急什么跟女朋友约什么有吗因为已经超过时间了我不想耽误你们啊没有 OK吗 OK 然后呢，如果我们走以后就怎么样呢？就解散这样，是不是？
是
就没了哈。OK， 有没有 bus 等你们什么？没关系啊，要不要多付钱呢、啊？没有哈。OK， 我再讲短短的一点。那个移教那个移教是不是啊？移教那个同期啊，他们说那个如果你要你的小孩啊，当那个第一流在那个随伴里面啊，你叫他坐在前面，那老师那个前面，一二三那个行那个前面。我说也许因为我坐每次都坐在前面，所以我在那个学班里面都是第一第二第三流的，真的也许有效的，这以我来讲是这样子。然后我那些坐那边都是很聪明的那学生，现在他们说他们在看为什么呢，大概因为坐前面的小孩都不能乱做什么事情，乱画名字什么，乱画手画脸在那个桌子上面，所以是听老师啊，所以学比较好。后面的一半哈、啊，都是写什么蛇啊、牛啊什么东西在桌子上面啊、椅子上面了、啊、吗？然后躲起来吃面包啊、啊馒头啊等等啊，所以就不专心，也许这样子，因为老师在后面管不了，看不大清楚啊。所以我说同样啊，你们做前面的人呢、啊，应该最有福报，最荣幸才对，最要小心啊！不要这样子亮来亮去。师傅下来以前已经宣布好，说我快下来了，还有15个分钟让他们乱跑了，快点回来。还是一样，我来了还是有几个人亮来亮去。那、在前面的做最前面是最要小心，因为后面的人全部都看到你。你坐最前面，你做什么都会影响到他们的，是不是？他们要听师傅，他们也会分心，太吵也不行。比方说大家排手，你也排，不要排比大家大，人家笑你也可以笑，不要故意笑比人家大，听懂吗？人家不笑的时候，你不要一个人哈哈出来这样子，吓死人了。比方说这样子，不用过分做什么嘛，做什么就自然就好了。应该也知道本分了、这边是大众，不是你一个人的地方。你们这样亮来亮去，我也分心啊，听懂吗？我不能跟你们说谎，我说你们做什么我都一心不乱的，这个是胡说。你就妨害我眼睛啊，有时候这样子还是有一点问题，不是没有啊，了解吗？
了解。
然后坐那边又故意，有时候还故意亮来亮去给师傅干了、因为如果我眼睛扫过去，跳过他，他就故意在那边弄什么的，听懂吗？我在这里，一定要给师傅看的，就这样子就更讨厌了。你了解我意思吗？你们不知道我坐这边啊，有手上坐在那针，那个好像椅子会长针一样。拜托啊！每一次缠缠缠气，我都发誓最后一次。然后后来就忘记了，跟你们生小孩一样，生一个说哇太烦了，以后不要再生了。然后就忘，他长大了就太可爱了，就想念那个小小的，又忘记又再生一个，然后说哦呀，这不行不行，以后不能再有生，然后又忘记了，每次都这样。OK， 我也希望我能常常忘记了，不然的话做不了这个世界的工作。我不知道为什么做这个工作很累啊。